If you follow intersectionality, you are not a Marxist. Identity politics and intersectionality are both born out of the degenerative idea of first worldism, basically the rejection of the idea that class has evolved since the 1850s. Now, not only have we seen capitalism evolve since that time, but Marx told us about it. He told us about the great dynamism of capitalism and how eventually it would change as a system over time, creating new contradictions and evolving the general system itself. These ideas of identity and these ideas of intersectionality are nothing more than the rejection of the evolution of class. I say this is first worldism because it avoids the revolution they know they can't achieve, and replaces it with something easier, reform from the bourgeois government. This is the safe thing to do, an easy thing to do. Revolution is violent and scary. The bourgeois is already giving these concessions to satisfy social peace because they do nothing to challenge the base of bourgeois power. This is why the Democratic Party is happy to pass bathroom bills and support eliminating other types of oppressions. Fundamentally, this only makes things easier for the bourgeoisie. If it were truly revolutionary, would the bourgeoisie be so happy to support it? The problem with ID poll and intersectionality is that they reject class. Now, if one is a liberal and rejects Marxism, this is all well and good. But if you claim to be a Marxist or even an anarchist, you're literally abandoning the ideology that you're supposed to be supporting. First worldists have abandoned the idea of building class struggle even if they are unwilling to consciously acknowledge it. Allow me to explain. Intersectionality is the idea that various forms of oppression intersect with each other. In other words, a person can have more than one form of oppression. However, this is reactionary liberalism. Now, the reason I say this is because that it does not focus on the systemic problems of society. It does not focus on how society interacts, but rather focuses on the individual oppressions of individual people. This hyper-focus on individualism is liberalism. Now, I know intersectionality supporting people claim the opposite. They are looking at systemic oppression in society. Despite this claim, they are wrong. We need only look at how they actually manifest so-called struggle and debate. We're familiar with oppression Olympics by individuals who uphold intersectionality. Oh yeah? Well, I'm a trans, black, lesbian, disabled, and you're just a gay male. Or, you're fucking a white male. You're wrong. Anyone with any sense of honesty would acknowledge that this is not an argument. This is not even engaging in debate. We've all seen this. This is nothing more than liberal individualism. They're literally focusing on the individual, not the actual issues. This happens constantly. Denying this is nothing less than straight-up dishonesty. Let's look at this from an even more pragmatic approach. Exactly what intersectional struggle ever led to a revolution? The answer is none. In fact, it deliberately distracts from revolution. People continually look for ways to make themselves seem more oppressed rather than organizing a revolution. Again, if you're a liberal, this makes sense. But if you claim to be a radical, this is a betrayal. Simple Marxism tells us that reform does not lead to revolution. Yet, these intersectionality and ID poll types keep telling us to vote for candidates that will make things easier for any of the various oppressed groups. Yes, they literally do this all the time. See Bernie Sanders. If you oppose this electoral reformism, you're accused of supporting whatever oppression is being voted on. So, the person advocating revolution as they're supposed to is being attacked, while the person advocating reform is the attacker, and yet, somehow, also the victim. If you cannot see the blatant anti-revolutionary nature of this, you are so far down the liberal rabbit hole that you can no longer see the sunlight. Be sure to immediately accuse the person pointing this out of being privileged in some way, even though it is not relevant to the argument. In fact, intersectionality has never led to revolution. Class struggle does. It makes no sense to spend resources on struggling equally for all forms of oppression when we well know they won't get the job done. Revolution. Thus, it makes sense to focus efforts primarily on the struggle that will lead to the end of all oppressions. To drain resources away from class struggle is no less than shooting yourself in the foot. Now, many who hold the position I just espouse immediately scream class reductionism, because they're incapable of formulating a coherent argument. The idea is that by placing a majority focus on class struggle, you're somehow directly supporting other forms of oppression. This is an outright liberal lie. By placing priorities, you're taking a scientific approach to achieving revolution, which, if you're a radical, you're supposed to be doing. Placing a majority or even equally spread support for other oppressions, you're literally pushing non-revolutionary struggles. Where has there been a revolution based on gender identity? Where has there ever been a revolution based on disability? None, ever. There is a reason for this. Some will even dishonestly point to the slave rebellion in Haiti under Louverture. However, they just seem to forget the idea that slave is a class, not an identity. It's a really existing material thing. As Marxists, we're supposed to understand base and superstructure. These idpole intersectional movements focus on the superstructure, the manifestation of the system, not the thing that makes the system what it is, the base. Now, the typical response to what I've just said is, other struggles can't wait. The irony of this is that no one is suggesting that. No one is doing that but the people who push intersectionality. We're suggesting placing a majority of effort into overthrowing the capitalist class so that the conditions can be created to end all forms of oppression. What these intersectionality liberals are trying to claim is that racism, sexism, homophobia can be abolished under capitalism. Now ask them if they can be abolished under capitalism. They'll tell you no, but for some reason focusing on class, which creates the conditions to eliminate the other oppressions, is saying that they don't matter. What's important here is the fact that the rejection of class struggle only makes the oppressions last longer. The longer it takes to getting around to doing revolution, the more harm is done to the oppressed people that the intersectional supporting people claim they are against. Their actions are the opposite. It does not stop the harm. In fact, it prolongs it. The problem with people that support intersectionality and idpole is that they offer no solution whatsoever. However, when you do point out the solution, that is to focus on class and building a revolution to eliminate these other oppressions, they openly oppose it and accuse anyone who supports it of supporting those oppressions which they are trying to eliminate. They will deny that they oppose revolution, but their actions literally demonstrate and achieve the opposite. They attack anyone who's trying to create the conditions to abolish all oppressions. Why? Because it doesn't focus immediately on them and their individual, real, and perceived oppressions. Once again, this hyper-focus on the individual is liberalism. It achieves absolutely nothing. Supporting intersectionality is blatantly anti-revolutionary. You are anti-revolutionary for supporting it. The proper outlook is contradiction as opposed to intersectionality, but that will have to wait for another video. There is no rational argument against what I've said here that does not end up by proxy claiming that oppressions can be defeated in capitalism. If revolution is the only way to do it, then class must be placed first. Now, as a final point, there does exist, of course, the argument that all of these things can be granted under capitalism. If one does indeed believe this, then the ball is really in the idpolar camp. Do you go ahead with class struggle revolution, or do you drop it entirely and pursue idpol reforms alone? Now, everyone, say it with me.
You're fucking a white male!
Thank you for watching. If you like this program, then please head over to my Patreon page and set up a monthly donation. It's your donations that keep this program running. Also, if you would like, please rate, comment, subscribe, and share in various social media.